Hello there. Good morning. You're watching Proactive London. So Bango hosted their annual strategy day on Wednesday with plans to become the technology behind every payment choice. Paul Larbey is here with us now to talk us through all of the details. So how did it all go?
Yeah, we really are. You say annual strategy day, but this is because of obviously lockdown and the pandemic. This is the first time we managed to get together face to face with investors since back in January 2020. So sadly not annual, but it was great to get everybody together. You know, in person, we had over 65 people attending. And because it was in person, we got to meet sort of people we haven't met for some time, but also a lot of new potential investors and some new analysts. And it also gave us the opportunity to not just sort of talk to people, which is absolutely great face to face, but also to show some demos, show how easy it is to share audiences, to allow people to target their Facebook campaigns, how easy the resale and bundling platform allows you to sign up for services such as Netflix. And we also had sort of video testimonials from a number of our customers like Microsoft and Skills. So yeah, all in all, a really great day. It was, and you know, really appreciate everybody's time for coming, but really productive, tiring, but a really, really great day.
Good. It certainly sounds it. And as you say, it's just nice to see people, isn't it? In real life and do something proper for a change. You did come out with a news publication yesterday just to let everybody know what was going to be happening in that strategy day. And there was the $7 million in annual recurring revenue from platform licensing deals by 2023. That certainly does sound impressive. Maybe tell us how that's going to be achieved.
Yeah, so if you step back, sort of historically as a company, prior to sort of 2020, really, the bulk of the revenue came from sort of these payments processing. And that was generally where we connect somebody who has a service to a paying user device, somebody who has a bill on which you can place that charge, quite often a sort of a telco bill or some other sort of bill. So that bundling of services or the direct charge of you buying a bag of gems in the Google Play Store. And that's allowed us to grow the business at around a sort of 52% CAGR over the past 5 years. So really great growth. And then the platform business sort of builds on top of that, and it comes from that resale and bundling where we're connecting subscription services to sort of telco broadband plans. And that's something we've been doing for sort of 2 or 3 years now. But the platform business is almost the flip side of it. It's sort of an incremental business, which is driven by once a telco does multiple services, there's a value in having a platform that brings them all together so they can generate recommendations for services that are specific for Paul or specific for Katie based on what other services you've taken out or what other services you're active or what's your sort of trends at the time. So we sort of spawned this sort of platform business, which uses exactly the same technology. But rather than just using it to connect, you know, a merchant A to sort of operator B, we now deploy it. So it's a single integration point for all our operators' third-party services. Allows them to bring them together in intelligent ways, manage things like creatives, get the right intelligence, allow them to attract, retain, and grow new customers. And so we started first with BT. We announced sort of back in 2020, sort of not that long ago, we talked about Verizon, which is our largest ever platform deal in this space. We have three other wins that sadly are not public yet, which we sort of told everybody about. And when you sort of put those five together, and because this is incremental revenue, it's much more of a SaaS-based model, they should be generating around $7 million of annual recurring revenue by 2023. So you sort of, you know, and that's just from those five. And we have, you know, really deep engagements with a whole host of other operators. And there are, you know, hundreds of telcos out there that this could apply to. So you can see where that $7 million is a really, really great start, but clearly only just the beginning.
Mm-hmm. And on the marketplace side of things, we've obviously seen strong growing numbers in your recent results, which we've spoken about a few times before. And you mentioned sort of six large customers paying $100K a year each. What is the opportunity there sort of going forward?
So again, I think if you look at how app developers generally use the sort of the bank audience, the audiences are using all that payment data that we've generated from the platform business and from that payment processing to create these audiences of users to better target your marketing. So you can go straight to the payers and sort of ignore the browsers to make sure all your advertising is targeted at the payers. And if you look at traditionally how app developers have sort of engaged with that model, they'll take an audience, it's a very compelling proposition, they'll try a few, then they'll try a few more audiences, then run multiple campaigns. And we've sort of, that's the sort of journey we've been on over the past sort of 12 to 18 months. And we've grown the number of app developers we're engaged with. It's in excess of 5,000 now. That's sort of 20x growth over 18 months. They're using more and more of those audiences. But at that right, the nice point now where we're sort of at a tipping point where a number are really starting to use them almost exclusively and putting huge volumes of ad spend through the Bango audiences. And the commercial model now is we take a percentage of the ad spend. So if you spend $100,000 on Facebook in a month, we'll take somewhere between 7 and 10% of that. So we were on this sort of nice journey where actually from only six of the sort of top 500 app developers, and clearly we're engaged with a lot more others, they're just not quite at that sort of level of maturity yet, where they're putting so much spend through the platform that they're generating around 100K of revenue a year each for us, just from those six. So you can see that six scaling up to the rest of the 500 and then outside the 500, you know, creates enormous opportunity. So really exciting. But I think that combination of growing app developers, growing use of audiences, and more spend through the audiences is, you know, makes the growth potential really exciting.
And what about any other additional opportunities you might look forward to?
Yeah, I think it's fair to say we're not short of opportunities. And if you think now we have these sort of three layers of business, the traditional sort of payments business that where we take a percentage of the user spend that's sort of been growing nicely. We overlay that with the incremental SaaS revenue. We overlay that with the sort of the marketplace business. And there's clearly, you know, there's more than enough for us to be looking at in those ones, and we'll be remain very focused on that. But if you step back and look at some of the trends in the industry, this the sort of the move to demonopolize billing within an app store, I think opens up other opportunities for the traditional payments business. And we see a lot of sort of momentum around that from app developers at the moment. On the licenses piece, we've always bundled services, not just with telcos, but with other verticals as well. Brick and mortar retailer, I think we spoke about in the past, energy sector we spoke about. So that license opportunity could very much expand outside the telco. And on the marketplace side, we know that purchase behavior targeting works outside of just app developers. We've moved even within app developers from games to online trading platforms to e-commerce, but we know it has broader appeal. But I think, you know, there's a massive opportunity out there. Really key for us is sort of continuing to focus, and that's what we'll be doing for the next couple of years. But certainly there's a big market out there we can attack.
And of course, with growth on the agenda, that comes with needing a bigger team, more talent. And I saw recently you added two new non-exec directors to the board. So how are they going to be helping with all of this growth?
Yeah, really, I'm really great timing. And luckily, Marcus Weldon, who's one of the new NEDs who joined us, so he more recently was the CTO of Nokia and I think was president of the labs for 8 years. A really strong innovator, very, you know, knowledgeable about telco, sort of based in the US. He was actually fortunately able to come over from the US and join us for Strategy Day. So he took the opportunity to meet investors for the first time at Strategy Day. And you know, he joined Bango because of this sort of a exciting transition between sort of the content with the sort of the web scale players and the telcos, and how Bango's platform is perfectly positioned in the middle to sort of benefit both. And that's why he joined us. And then Lisa Gansky also joined us. She's also based in the US, long track record from sort of founding companies with AOL and obviously one of the first photo sharing sites with Kodak, multiple sort of entrepreneurial activities since in disruptive technologies. So bringing sort of two international NEDs with really strong experience in growth and really, you know, disruptive technologies and innovators will really sort of help us as a board. And certainly they'll be pushing me to sort of focus more on the future and look at some of the opportunities ahead of us. But I think being able to bring in such strong talent onto the Bango board, I think is testament to the power of the Bango platform and its attractiveness that we see, not just in sort of the sales we generate with customers, but the fact that we can bring on people like Lisa and Marcus, who are, you know, very clearly in demand in the industry. So we're really pleased about that, and it's great to have them on board.
Mm-hmm. And what's the key message that you hope investors took away from the day then, Paul?
I think it's growth. I think all about growth. We've always said we're all about growth. The nice thing is we're funding that growth from our own cash. The one thing we talked a little bit about with investors is that we're going to need to sort of these sort of organic areas of growth come back to raise any money. So there's sort of no dilution. So we're going to continue to grow from their own cash. But there's this massive opportunity for growers. And we're clearly on a multi-year journey. And historically, with that 52% CAGR of revenue we've seen, we think it's just the beginning. You go back sort of 5-6 years, we were single millions of dollars of revenue. We're now tens of millions of dollars of revenue. And clearly there's a very clear path to $100 million worth of revenue. And that's what we're going to continue to execute and focus on. And yeah, and so hopefully they'll be excited about that and continue to invest. But yeah, great day. And that growth is hopefully the key message they went away with.
It's all about the growth. Paul, thank you so much. From Bango here on Proactive London, it's Paul Larbey.